Hello guys, today I want to show you how to build a binary subtractor. Usually, a binary subtractor is built with an adder, and the second number gets inputted in the 2's complement state. And this is nice and it works, but it's usually much lower than a real binary subtractor that is designed to subtract two numbers. Since you have to think like that, an adder is actually meant to add two numbers, and using 2's complement and make a subtractor like this is slower than building a subtractor circuit that can subtract on its own. Now, to show you how a subtractor works, I firstly built an adder, like you probably should know it. It's built a bit bigger to see how it works. We have 2 XOR gates, 2 AND gates, and a OR gate for our carry. And this works just fine. It can fully add those 3 numbers together, our carry and our 2 input numbers. And if we look here, this is now a subtractor circuit, and it looks pretty similar. It's actually exactly the same, at least almost. We still have 2 XOR gates, 2 AND gate, and an OR gate, but as you can see, on the A input, we invert our AND gate input. On the adder, it's not inverted, but here it's inverted since the torch is missing. And in our half subtractor, the result of the half subtraction here is also inverted in our AND gate. And this is everything you need to change in an adder to make it to a subtraction circuit. And this explains also why the subtractor is faster than a adder that has been redesigned with 2's complement to a subtraction circuit. Now I can demonstrate it to you. If we enable our A input, that would be 1 minus 0. And we see our result bit is on, so it displays a 1. Now if we subtract 1 minus 1, we get a 0 at our output. And if we subtract 0 minus 1, we get a minus 1 in the 2's complement state. So obviously negative numbers always get put out in the 2's complement, as always, and we could technically also subtract 0 minus 2, which is a minus 2 in 2's complement. And that would be 1 minus 2, which is minus 1 again in 2's complement. So you can see the subtractor works just fine, and you can connect it to, in this case, it's not a carry, as you can see, it's a borrow bit. So they call it borrow since it's not adding plus 1, it's subtracting minus 1. And our carry out is now labeled as borrow out. And if you want to have multiple bits, we can simply just connect the borrow out of the previous bit to the borrow in of the next bit. Now, this is obviously a bit large design, so I made a much smaller design out of it, and it looks similar to a binary adder, just with some adjustments. So we have our subtracting function, and it works exactly the same. 1 minus 0 is 1, 1 minus 1 is 0, 0 minus 1 is minus 1 in 2's complement, and 0 minus 2 is minus 2 in 2's complement. So it works just fine. I will show how to build this thing shortly, but before I show you a 4-bit subtractor example, as you can see, you simply connect the borrow out of the previous adder to the borrow in of the next the borrow out of the previous subtractor to the borrow in of the next subtractor. And our last bit here, This one shows if our result is negative or positive. So if we have this bit on, it's a negative result, or even when it's off, it's a positive result. And if the result is negative, we get the 2's complement result. Now, to demonstrate this thing to you, let's do some calculations. Let's start with 12 minus 6. And if we look at our result, we have the fourth bit and the second bit on, so we have A6 as a result. So the subtraction was correct. If we, for example, would do 12 minus 2, we get a 10 as result. The 8 and the 2's bit is on. And let's do 15 minus 5. And we get a 10 as a result too. Or let's say 50 minus 7, which is 8, yes. And let's do some negative one negative example. Let's say 3 minus 5. And now you can see a minus 2 in 2's complement, and our largest bit here is on. So now I show you how to build one bit of this subtractor circuit. Let's start with an XOR gate. That's a different design of XOR gate. We build like an X here, and then 2 blocks extended like this. We place 3 redstone torches like this. 1 redstone dust here, 2 redstone dust there, and 2 redstone torches here, and 2 redstone dusts like this. And this is a XOR gate. And on a regular adder circuit, we could do our carry bit like this. But that's not what we want. Instead, on the left side where our A input is, we place a torch on the side like this, a block on top, and a torch on top. This is our inverted AND gate input now. And for the other side, we place a redstone on top of this block, then a block here to block this off. So this redstone wire doesn't connect with this. Since this redstone wire is an AND gate, so this one would only turn off if both redstone torches are off, but we want to have it off when this redstone torch is off. And now we simply place some blocks above like this and connect the redstone wire down like this. And now we created this AND gate. It's this inverted input plus this input uninverted, which is exactly the same like I showed it in here. You can see our B input is not inverted, but our A input is inverted. And that's exactly the same thing. And then we place a redstone torch here. And that would be the half subtractor. To get a full subtractor, we need to build the same thing again. So we place our XOR gate again. We place the redstone torch here, a block on top of it, another redstone torch, redstone dust here, 3 blocks like this, 3 redstone wires like this, 1 block down here, 1 redstone dust, and to line this up, I place another block, and then the redstone torch. And that we are done. This is our one bit of a full subtractor. And to label everything, oops. We have our A input here, our B input here. Then we have our borrow in input here. This is our result output bit, and this is our borrow out. Now that's everything I wanted to show you. I hope you learned something new, and see you next time. Bye.